Central Region Championship post-game press conference. We'll start with an opening statement from head coach, and then if you have questions towards either of these two players or the coach, please identify yourself and the organization you're with, and we'll go from there. The final score today, MSU 43, Northwest Missouri State 42. Congratulations to Northwest Missouri State on a tremendous tournament. We're joined by Ben McCollum, the head coach, sophomore guard Bennett Stirts, and junior forward Daniel Abreu. And Ben, if you'd like to make a statement.
Yep, congrats to the players from Minnesota State. They played an excellent game. They played tough, they played physical, and it's one of those games that it's just a fun environment, fun game, and a joy to be a part of. Personally for us, I think that we had a group that really fought and continues to fight, and it doesn't feel totally over. I think that tonight, that last deal, that was probably on me, and we had tried to foul, 5 seconds ago, we had three fouls, and so you kind of foul early, but we just hadn't practiced that, and so we didn't end up fouling him, and then they got a clean look at it, which is tough, and he hit a big shot, and just one of those deals. I thought we battled, I thought we played fantastic, missed a couple free throws and a couple bad bounces, and that's kind of the way the game went, but this group we're proud of, the seniors I'm proud of. Proud of the way they competed tonight, proud of the way they competed all year, proud of the way that, people said that this is a down year and whatnot, and, I thought we were just as good as ever. And disappointed we couldn't win the game, but tough game.
Open it up for questions here for any of the players. Identify yourself and the organization you're with. Yep.
John Dykes from Maryville Forum. Coach, Isaiah's defensive job tonight against Malik Willingham, holding the 4 points. What did you say at the end of the floor? Obviously, it wasn't just him when you hold a team like that to 43 points.
Yeah, he was unbelievable. I thought our whole group was just really dialed in because they're a really good offensive team. And Isaiah just, he's just hard to screen. He can get out in front of angles. He executed the scout to perfection, made him take really difficult shots all night long, and probably played as good a defense as you could possibly play. And that's why it's unfortunate that we lost the game.
Yeah, big guys, strong players, constantly took it at us to the rim, and it was hard to guard at some points, as you can see, we're here. Props to those guys were great players.
Daniel, all kind of this tournament run, Mac's been talking about your continued growth, especially offensively. Just what has been that key for you, and having 17 tonight, what has changed offensively for you this second half of the season?
I want to attribute it to anything in particular. I always go back to this, but I think it's so true. It's just the role. I'm filling a role that someone left that previous year. Things are starting to click. I see opportunities, take the opportunities, and that's that.
Brett Kennedy, KP2 Sports. Coach, what do you have to say? Final message for your seniors on this team here from a great season?
I mean, just, those two are just, they led the way. Wes and Mitch and just everyday guys, just awesome human beings. And they're just a joy to coach. I've got to coach both of them for 5 years, and I'll miss doing it every single day, miss seeing them every single day. And they're going to be elitely successful people. And, Wes played obviously with a fractured wrist for the last month and a half or whatever. And Mitch has been fantastic leadership wise, hit big shots, hit a big one tonight. And I'm always going to miss him.
Coach, obviously, seeding in the region, being able to host, you guys have done it numerous times. Obviously, that plays a big part. The crowd they had tonight, certainly against you, and because you guys have hosted and done extremely well at your place. But that regular season really means something when you get to those rankings for the region.
Yeah, for sure. And I thought we performed. Obviously, we had a lot of injuries early in the season and played a full play a full D2 schedule. You know, once we got healthy, once we got Isaiah back, and then we started to roll a little bit, and our kids started to play really well, and that's where the streak kind of went.
Coach, you mentioned a second ago with Mitch hitting big shots, but that one he hit there, he was 0-for-5 to that point, and then got, I think they were up at that point, or it was tied, and he hit a big one to get you guys back in front. So talk about that shot.
Yeah, it was a good shot. I mean, it was a big-time shot. And then we had a second one there. We ran a play to him, and, man, that was dead on, too. Just ball didn't bounce. And, you know, I mean, but it's just you're still right. You foul, you know, you win the game. And we didn't, and that's my fault. But, yeah, he's hit big shots all season. He had one game where he won it by himself. I mean, he's been awesome.
Wesley Miller for Northwest Missouri. This is a question for Bennett and Danny. Both of as kind of coach talked about Wes and Mitch and their timing program. You guys have kind of had a bit of a different length with those guys. Just talk about, you know, your experiences with them and just how much they've meant to you.
They've meant so much to me. Personally, they've been huge role models for me, and I look up to them. And hopefully I can be like them one day.
Yeah, Wes is a big mentor for me. Not as much Mitch as a mentor because he's a huge shooter and that's not my role. But I love and cherish those friendships that I have with them. Great people, and I'm gonna miss them terribly.
Matt, Wes has been in the program longer than anybody at this point. What, if you can, share what you said to him after the game?
We haven't talked, me and him, yet, other than just in the deal. It's, you know, when you lose one of those kind of deals, it doesn't feel like it's really over. It's just kind of like you get done and you're like, what just happened? Like, we should have won the game. So we'll talk I mean, it's when you're right after a game, it's like, you know, what do you say? Well, what's going to make it feel better? Like, there's absolutely nothing that's going to make it feel better. But then you give it a day and then you have conversations, and that's the direction we'll go.
Thank you guys for joining us. Safe travels, a tremendous tournament.
Congratulations on a great year.
Thank you.